The purpose of this video is to talk about the term puberty. What is puberty? And also a couple of terms that are associated with early onset of puberty, which is secular trend and precocious puberty. So what is puberty? So this is a time when a child's body develops and changes into an adult, resulting in sexual maturity and the ability to reproduce. So it occurs between 3 to 5 years. Usually for girls, it occurs between the ages of 10 to 14. And for boys, it occurs between the ages of 12 to 16. And this is the second time in a person's life when there is rapid growth and development. The first time was in infancy, but now this is the second time. And for example, the lungs, they triple in weight, and the heart doubles in size, but the heartbeat slows down. And it is essential at this time for the adolescent to get enough sleep. But we all know that this is also the time where it's really difficult because of more demanding academics and sports activities and other extracurricular things and after school jobs and just so much to do in high school to prepare for the next stage in life. So there is a term, secular trend, which means that the age of puberty has been decreasing over time. So in the early 1900s, puberty started about ages 16 to 17, but now it's normal for a child to develop or to go into puberty about around the ages of 12 to 13, or even 10 to 11. And that leads to the term precocious puberty. Precocious puberty is early puberty. And so for girls, that's about age 8. For boys, it's about age 9. And this is an age where if they enter puberty, that medical advice or treatment should be sought because it can help slow down this process. And you might wonder, but why? Why is there a concern for early onset of puberty? Well, let me show you. So reasons why entering puberty at an early age is cause for concern includes the following. Kids who enter puberty early may be shorter because growth stops once puberty ends, and the length of precocious puberty is shorter than normal puberty. Also, girls usually stop growing a year after their period starts. Then, because these bodily changes occur earlier than the child is emotionally and physically ready to handle it, sometimes precocious puberty can lead to depression. Research has also shown that there is a slight increase in risk for cancer, in particular breast cancer for girls. Also, since the child may feel stress or depression with early puberty, they may be more likely to abuse drugs or alcohol at an earlier age. The hormones involved in puberty signal that the child is now sexually mature, and they might have sex at an earlier age, and that may result in other issues such as low birth weight babies and exposure to sexually transmitted infections. So what is the cause of precocious puberty? Why are we seeing an increase of precocious puberty among children in the past few decades? Well, there's lots of ideas and theories out there. You know, what are we being exposed to? What are we feeding our kids? And so a few ideas are definitely diet related. One is the increase of processed foods and the increased use of chemicals in our processed foods, and also hormones, the hormones that they give to the animals that we eat to make them grow faster. And so then they can mature faster, and then we can put them into our diets and also into the dairy products. And so those are some ideas about why precocious puberty or early onset of puberty is occurring. And also, if a child is obese, then there is a higher chance that they will go through precocious puberty, since the increased amount of body fat can lead to early onset of puberty. So what can we do to decrease the risk of kids going through precocious puberty? Well, if it's diet related, we can definitely help the child to decrease the amount of processed foods that they eat, and choosing meats and dairy products that do not use the growth hormone, and just to be able to have a healthy diet and increase the amount of vegetables that they eat. And another thing, if obesity is a problem, then encouraging exercise. So go out and exercise, get some fresh air, or even just move around more. And so that way they can develop the healthy habits that they can carry on throughout their life, not just to decrease the chances of precocious puberty, which is obviously important, but just also to establish the healthy habits that will help them through their life.